nor to institute proceedings for contempt of court as the case may be. That High Court shall make rules in exercise of the powers conferred by Article 2043 of the Constitution to ensure independence of the judiciary and to devise a mechanism for taking stringent action against all those who interfere with judicial work or malign members of the judiciary. Four, that it shall be mandatory for every judicial officer to report interference in judicial work, whether through intimidation or otherwise, to the High Court, through the district judge and or inspection judge within 7 days, and failure in this regard may amount to misconduct.
There is also an additional note filed by Justice Ijaz.
Actual position. I have this letter which says the additional note, and then with this letter.
ये बताइए
जी. अच्छा,
ये kindly please will you read Justice Ijaz's note.
ये बताइए, ये जो चीजें चार पॉइंट्स हैं, can the High Court do it itself or not under the Constitution?
High Court can, and I think no one can disagree with.
Where is the Constitution provisions? Read the Constitution provisions.
My Lord, Article 203. And then the High Court rules under which the administration committee is constituted. With regards to the district judiciary, each High Court shall supervise and control all courts subordinate to it.
Two of these provisions do not come within the domain of the High Court.
My Lord, I think all of them, the High Court can.
Now, I pose a constitutional question to you. If we direct the High Court, are we acting in accordance with the Constitution? Are we undermining the independence of the High Court?
My Lord,
because you see, we have to be very, very careful. We should also not interfere in the workings of the High Courts. Because there have been instances where the Supreme Court has interfered in the workings of the High Court and the results have not been good. So if these are the proposals, the High Court can implement them tomorrow.
Mr. Learned Attorney General,
hello.
First let us appreciate which each High Court is saying. What phenomena are they highlighting? Then we can come to this. Because if the institution, within the institution there is a culture that there will be no response, that judges can never be fearless. So before,
well, let's read through, the next one then. Let's read all of them. Which one are you reading next?
उससे पहले जरा अगर आप जस्टिस इजाज का नोट पढ़ लें.
Our order had restricted ourselves to the High Courts. Now, if we read, each judge keeps sending things separately, we can read all of them, and of course we will be benefited from them as well. But then our order did not say that. Either they said, he should say, I don't agree with this note, then it's a different matter. I don't understand. It's not a judgment that is being written. I write a separate note. The court has agreed. We can read it later. I think the High Court's...
Leonard, Attorney General, I think to appreciate Islamabad High Court's point of view, let us read it on record.
Conclusions. A.
Well, which page are you?
Page 11 of this note, sir, which is the additional note, but obviously the original is signed by the entire High Court. It's the full.
G.
Conclusions. A. Mandatory reporting with consequences for not reporting, followed by escalation to judicial contempt on inaction on the report. B. promulgation of the judicial, within brackets, institutional code of conduct for all tiers of the judiciary. C, revisions to the High Court rules, one, to vest the functions of bench formation and case listing in the Administrative Committee in line with the Supreme Court Practice and Procedure Act 2023. Two, to eliminate misuse of administrative powers for targeted judicial outcomes. And three, to reinvigorate the institution of the full court within the disciplines appropriate to a corporate body. D, promulgation of code of conduct and ethics for the subordinate judiciary. E, promulgation of rules for the conduct of judicial contempt under Article 2043 of the Constitution. F, parliamentary hearings on reference by the full court as an institutional remedy adjunct to the contempt remedy. These are the conclusions. I may now read out the Lahore High Court, sir. It's CMA 3610, sir. Page 2, sir.
Relevant part, sir. When the meeting was held,
Leonard Attorney General, page 7 mein para 2 pad lijiye.
Ji, ji. Ye page 6 se shuru hota hai na, inki recommendation, wo padhe na, para 2 se shuru hota
hai. Ji, ki baat kar rahe hain. So page 7 onwards, sir.
Yes, no, page 6 se niche se paragraph 2 se shuru.
Ji, ji. Paragraph 2, the participants thereafter turn by turn expressed their views in detail on the issue. It was concluded in the full court meeting as under.
Yes, page 7.
One. All the judges of this court unanimously appreciate the above mentioned order, that is order dated 3-4-2024 in suo motu case number 1 of 2024 of the Honorable Supreme Court of Pakistan, whereby it is directed that the high courts as well as
this other is not really a proposal or suggestion.
Leonard Attorney General, para 2.
It is considered to be very encouraging for the judges of this court that the Honorable Supreme Court of Pakistan has passed the above mentioned order for the first time in the judicial history of this country to address the most sensitive and grave issue being faced by the judges of the superior courts as well as by the judges of the district judiciary.
Idhar ruk chahiye, what are they saying? That this is a continuing and persistent phenomena.
It was further observed that the principle of trichotomy of power is well entrenched in the Constitution, which guarantees judicial independence at the institutional level, including the individual judges. The constitutional norms dictate that government, its institution agencies must respect and observe the independence of the judiciary. The constitutional guarantee of independence of the judiciary ensures rule of law, realization of fundamental rights, and stability of the society. A functional democracy and civilian supremacy are affected and materialized in the presence of a vibrant, free, independent and neutral judiciary. The freedom granted to the judges to decide cases according to their oath, uninfluenced by other factors, is crucial for equality of parties before the courts. Three, it was further unanimously resolved that no one should get an impression that there is any division or grouping in the judges of this court, Lahore High Court within brackets, on account of minor differences of opinions or dissenting notes given in the judgments, because the impression of division or grouping in the judiciary is intentionally highlighted by some individuals on the electronic, print and social media for the benefit of the third party. Therefore, there should be a loud and clear message that all the judges of this court are standing united, and they also fully support the Honorable Chief Justice and Honorable Judges of the Supreme Court of Pakistan, who have been dealing with such like issues and other most sensitive matters of the country with courage and bravery.
This is the paragraph which is very important, para 4.
It is also unanimously proposed that the code of conduct of the judges of the superior judiciary and district judiciary may be amended, and there should be a complete ban on the meetings of the judges with the members of the agencies, save in the cases of close blood relationships. It should be made mandatory for every judicial officer to immediately disclose to the district and sessions judge, the Chief Justice of the High Court, and to the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court of Pakistan if any attempt is made to interfere in his judicial work. A permanent cell may be constituted at the High Court and the Supreme Court level to process such reports of legal complaints and their decisions in accordance with the law. 5. The agencies, individuals involved in phone tapping.
Because in Baluchistan, the lower judiciary did not have a code of conduct. Does the Lahore judiciary have it?
I think the High Court rules and orders, there is a conduct for the district judiciary.
Rules and orders, Lahore High Court ka mangwaye.
Code of conduct hai, district judiciary ka pata hai. I think that's been adopted by some of the other high courts. You can read para 5.
Para 5. The agencies oblige individuals involved in phone tapping or audio oblique video recording, etc. of the judges and their families be identified and proceeded against in accordance with the law. 6. If a judge of the High Court or district judiciary is approached, intimidated or blackmailed by any member of the state agency's oblique executive, then the said judge, apart from taking oblique initiating other legal proceedings against the responsible person, may also initiate contempt proceedings against him, them, or he may proceed in the matter as envisaged under section 228 PPC as the case may be. 7. The Chief Justice, the District and Sessions Judge and the judge himself should immediately try to secure the CCTV camera recordings, phone recordings or other evidence which can be secured through modern devices, etc. in case any attempt or interference in the independence of judiciary is made by the executive oblique agencies.